Welcome back to our MedSmarter lecture series, where we're taking a smarter approach to preparing future physicians. Before we get started, if you'll take just a quick minute and click that like button, and also subscribe and turn the bell on so that you'll be notified when we post new videos. Let's continue on with our discussion of Gram positive organisms. Today we're going to cover Bacillus cereus. Bacillus cereus is a Gram positive rod. As you can see here in this picture, these are colonies of Bacillus cereus that have been grown on a sheep blood auger plate. The main problem that Bacillus cereus can cause is food poisoning. And what happens here is that we have spores that can survive cooking if the temperature of the food is not brought to the correct temperature. So with this specific instance, rice is one of the most common locations to find Bacillus cereus, specifically in reheated rice. What is happening is the cooking temperatures originally were not high enough, allowing some of these spores to survive during cooking. And then if they are improperly refrigerated, the endospores can then germinate. And then with reheating, not getting it back up to a proper temperature can allow those germinated spores to survive and to cause infection. So the important thing here is to make sure that we keep rice warm above 50 degrees Celsius or at refrigerated temperatures below 10 degrees Celsius. There are two different types of Bacillus cereus infections that we can have. It's the emetic type and the diarrheal type. The emetic type is what causes nausea and vomiting specifically, and that's typically within 1 to 5 hours of ingestion of those spores. This is caused by the cereulide preformed toxin. The diarrheal type causes watery, non-bloody diarrhea as well as GI pain, and that typically onsets within 8 to 18 hours of ingestion. The management for a Bacillus cereus infection is just a supportive care. There's really no other treatment that is beneficial for Bacillus cereus besides supportive care. So trying to make sure your patient's comfortable, that their fluid status is good, and this is a self-limiting problem. If you found this material helpful for your studying, please like and consider subscribing to the channel. Also, share this video so that more people can benefit from it like you have.